Yeah. You niggas better be forewarned. Motherfuckers think they hard like that. You know what I'm saying? They come through deep. And they come through deep when you not looking. So for all of you multicultural motherfuckers talking that bullshit, to have multicultural, and I am a strong multiculturalist. I am 100% anti-integration. It's like, it's 9:30. They just came through the big mob. That's the Hasidic Jewish heads. This is downtown Brooklyn. This is supposed to be blackness. It ain't blackness no more, but it's just saying. On the outskirts of black Brooklyn. I'm sure they popping up as well. So they like two blocks ago. They two blocks away now. They way down there. I still hear them yelling they shit. Even if it don't pick up on this, I hear them. You know what I'm saying? And they all through the communities. I was just having a conversation with a brother. You know what I'm saying? Because he saw a couple of whatever earlier going this way. That was like 6 o'clock or something. And I told him about this experience where in Fort Greene, Brooklyn, right here, that's between BAM, Brooklyn Academy of Music, Brooklyn Technical High School, Brooklyn Tech, or Lafayette Avenue on the A train, there's a little triangle park. And now, understand, this is a community, you know what I'm saying, with ordinance and whatever have you. And white people are moving in, but it's still a black neighborhood for all intents and purposes. So it's half and half, because that's the neighborhood generated near the Barclays Center. So by default, my part of town gonna get beat down. But this is it's October 2:15. The springtime. When the springtime came in, or the coldness let up, they had a ritual monument right in the middle of town. Here's the thing, this is a black neighborhood being infiltrated or gentrified by white people. These people are not even in the neighborhood. And they put forth a big ritual smack center in the middle of it that looked like a big giant square. Like a big, I don't know, like a giant sized grill. It was some type of altar. Basically, they put forth an altar, a humongous altar in the middle of the neighborhood that they was consuming or enraging a giant fire in the middle of a community. You know what I'm saying? If any black person in the community would have even set foot on that spot and had an open barbecue, they'd have been annoyed away, or something. They'd have been aggravated away, or they'd have been dealt with. They're not even a part of the community, and they set up an altar. I mean, a big ass altar, a big giant thing, and blazed up a fucking bonfire, basically. Basically, these dudes put up a bonfire in the middle of the hood. A bonfire. And it's all good. That's for letting them motherfuckers come around you. And for letting them motherfuckers own your shit. They should not, you know what I'm saying? You gotta put them in their place. And their place is outside of your community. They can't have their tentacles in it. And if they own the buildings you live in, guess what? They got their tentacles in it. So now that they've gentrified the black neighborhood enough, now they bold enough to come walking through that shit with their family. What I mean, their family. With their women and children. Because before, you only saw them. And they landlord in stilos. You saw they women on TV. And if you cross and you go in Williamsburg. Now they deep in the hood. They're not even near the hood, but they deep in the hood, coming through 50 deep. I've seen it deeper than that. 50 deep with strollers. 50 deep as a children class. They going on more trips, more class trips to the park than the people that live in the place. It's real funny. I'm saying. But they come through sublimely when you're not looking and get comfortable. So when you finally see them, guess what? They already been there. You just didn't pay attention. You didn't notice. Plus, they come through when you don't notice anyway, so. Just because you don't know what's going on, it ain't your fault to say you're not the victim of that shit. You should not know what's going on. And right now, it's too late to revamp that, so we have to go forth anew, with a new intent in mind. We can't reverse what's happening. We can put forth a new agenda,